Welcome to Leicester BarFights.
What's the date?
Hello.
20 something.
21st of February 2020. We have got some Street Fighter 4 action. As always, I am joined by...
Sid.
Sid. The evil man of the and Gamma Slap myself. No Indy this week. We're missing the American Heights. It's alright.
We're going to have to manufacture some American Heights.
First up, we've got
like those Twinkies.
Zaus versus One More Thing. Why is it called One More Thing?
Jackie Chan, the cartoon.
Godlike.
The old guy. I think it's basically
more.
That.
Okay, that's what he's got like. So who's versus Cammy? Cammy wins this, right?
So well, Cammy should win. Cammy, I would call this a 6-4. I don't know what a rogue player would say. I mean, a rogue player would obviously...
From what I hear, rogue players always say everything is 7-3 against you.
So, Rob's doing a good job of just keeping out, really. He's playing his own game at the minute.
That's what I think, against a player like Ben, Zao's going to you first need to whittle him down, because if you go at him too hard, that happens.
Yeah.
And it'll pick you out.
Rob's
doing a good job, though. He's spacing his side kicks in a place where it'll catch poke.
He's only going in on the advantage, yeah.
Oh dear, that was a big mistake, but... Oh, he's such a sniper with that.
Good effort. Walks up, waits a little bit, then presses the button. Good delay. Rob, maybe she would have thought about that back from there.
That's exactly what. When he walks at me, I'm like, I'm out of it. I'm out. Oh, that was a beautiful forward round. That was taking.
I don't know why more people don't play it.
I think there's because a lot of Street Fighter, four players in general, most of the time. But if you are, the game really works for you. The Daigo's example, he plays for you and he still wins almost everything. What's going on here?
So Rob's gone back to the same plan as the start of the last round. If he sticks to it,
there we go.
He should be fine.
That's what I like to see Rob land his combo. I like that. I know he's a good player. I'll play him in casual.
Yeah, just consistency is the main hurdle to get over.
Oh, no! He just needs to wait this out here. He can't die. No matter what happens,
he
can't die.
Just needs to walk up and block. Don't lose the screen space.
There we go. There we go. Good decision. Takes the chip. Cammy living up to that top tier status right there, going in.
So one more thing needs to, if he doesn't stay out, he's going to get supered. And then that's going to be the base of the round over.
Yeah, he needs to stay well out of her forward medium range. Oh no! Oh, he didn't cancel.
He gets to stay in the super for the next one that kills.
Spot up, yeah. Oh no, that was a very...
Surprised in that situation. If that ever happens again, it's very likely to never happen again. But yeah. Rob should mash Ultra next time he sees that.
Oh, that's an important. He went for the dive kick there. I think he's trying to make the crouch tech or some form of tech to get the X. Oh, he gets a good jump in. Oh, he gets the next
hit anyway. That's Cammy back.
Oh my good god, so good at that.
Rob chooses to give up the screen space to try and time out. Unfortunately, gets caught standing up and then the slide.
That ultra 2 is really good. On the surface, it doesn't look very good, but it is.
It's certainly a good tool. It's obviously if you say that Dawson's Ultra 1 is to be used to get him screen space, Rose's is twice as good as that for that person.
Just walk at you. What is that move even called? Soul Spark, yeah. Throw one of them to walk at you.
Soul Fist.
Let's leave that out. I'm sick of seeing that move. How would you do it?
That's good to know that Rose can do that. That means that Rob can't really go for the cross up.
I mean, it doesn't hurt the game too much. I mean, Cameron's all about that counter pressure, but Ben is effectively removing that option from the game, so...
I mean, he has to keep hitting in front until he is confident that Ben has forgotten about the fact that Rob wants to go behind.
Or he has no meter, which he doesn't currently.
True. Did he move before that one?
Yeah, it's EX. The EX one's like pretty invincible. Oh, he hits him again with that counter it.
This is the thing that happens against Ben. You play patient in the first round. He might steal the game from you, and then you just want to start pressing buttons.
Yeah. That's what I want to see, more of that. More wake up DP, just do it.
Ah, no punishing the coach. The reason he didn't punish with a barrel arrow there is because you can easily get an accidental DP there and make yourself open.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Like forward, plus quarter circle, forward equals DP. Of course.
Oh, there we go. That's the boxing up. Very good. Use that. Use that more. Yeah, definitely focus those. Oh, that was a bad
idea. I'd like to see Rob just chill out.
Yeah, Rob's got maybe, the lead. Maybe, going.
Maybe get on the other side and then just chill out a little bit more and wait for the gap. Maybe wait for Rose to get bored and use the ultra.
I mean, he should go back to what faithful there. Just walk up and use standing rounds. It's worked.
Yeah, it got him a fair chunk of damage just now.
Oh, Ben's locked him in the corner. It's a bad place to be. Oh, he walked. So ballsy. I like it. Oh, this could be real bad because he's within chip.
You get lucky with an ultra or something.
Oh no,
That's the problem with that fireball.
Rob played really well in that match.
Absolutely.
Really well indeed.
It's only a matter of time before Ben's...
Ben's...
on the losing side of those
iron
those armor head-to-head.
Is cracked. It's rusting every week, you know.
So who we got next?
Oh, it's Mr. Stabby sitting there.
That looks like it's... Stabby versus Ocelot. Rob versus Declan.
Oh,
I hope
we're
going to see Rufus versus Sagat.
I don't know if Declan's still playing Gat. He said that he was having trouble with
Sagat. He said to me just now that Declan's happiest playing Sagat because he feels like that's the character that identifies with him the best.
Yeah. Very selfish, though.
But he has spoken with a fondness for Cammy's bullshit. So if he learns Cammy, I'd love to see it.
Man, he would play the lamest Cammy that would just explode on you at any moment and then walk to the other side of the screen. That's how Deccan plays.
As much as I'd hate to say it, that's what every character needs to do in this game, though.
Yeah.
But I don't like seeing it. I like doing it, but I don't like seeing it.
You see a lot of people lose because they just press.
Yes.
And then inevitably you are going to get DP'd at some point if they've got one. So.
Yeah.
It happens. Who's it going to be? Oh, we're getting a gap. We've got the King versus the Burger King. Let's go. I love Burger King.
Very good.
I'm secretly hoping for a Rob win. He's been putting in loads of work with Rufus.
When he played last week at Northampton,
different person.
If he'd gotten those ultras, it would have been a different game.
Yeah, I was thinking the same. Rufus is real dangerous even without combos, that's the thing. Once he gets the one frame link down as well, he'll just be even more scary.
Rufus is a bit of a high entry level character for that reason. Get the bread and butter with the one frame link in it. Blinking obviously makes that easier.
Oh, good job baiting out the DP there. Man. So that's DP reverse and not that great.
Yeah, if you want to use it as a reversal, you almost have to use it as a non-reversal by delaying it a little bit and then using it to get out of safe jump setup.
Rob fishing for that there. I don't know if you've seen it, but it was towards roundhouse twice into medium snake spike into ultra once, 505 damage.
Oh my goodness. That
no meter.
Second combo.
It's just like.
Next time Declan sees that Rob does a Galactic Tornado from full screen, he should be pumping the ultra.
Or the Tiger Knee, because that's the best way to slow him down. Rob can still win this, it only takes a target combo to ultra. Oh, he's got the sweep, this could be it. I didn't go for it. I'm very surprised.
Very good patience by Declan. He could have done something with a little bit more risk, like an EX Tiger Knee into an uppercut to get the chip damage, but I like that he didn't, because it's a good habit to not start doing that.
Yeah, I mean, that spacing on the Bible was very good. It's really tricky to space with Sagat. Walk speed is very slow.
Yeah, his walk speed is very slow, and his fireballs are quite a commitment.
Yeah. I mean, he's doing a good job here, keeping him in the corner like he should. That forward throw is so damaging, like 130. Oh, that was interesting. Rufus all the meat off. What's going on?
Not choosing to go for a save jump, he's choosing to back off.
Oh,
I'd have liked to
have
really
doesn't have it, he doesn't have it. Yeah. Oh, very good.
He's not getting into form now, he's hitting that stride with the Rufus pressure.
Steam him that Rufus boot.
We like to see it until we see it too much and then we'll hate it.
Yeah, and then we'll just fuck this character. It's kind of like Gen, you first see it from Gen, you're like, wow, and then you're like, this is bullshit. I hate this character.
She's not used to see if it would have worked in that range from Montreal.
I think Lucas' super is quite possibly the most laziest piece of animation in this game. It's whack whack, very slow wheel back, palm. That's all it is. It looks cool though, but it's
the
noisy real lazy. Well.
I can't agree with the noisy mixture in that.
Rob needs to chill out and just listen to his bands without, you know, taking too much damage. Take a chip's fine. There you go. Declan really should be DPing that, but...
Yeah, Declan was looking for a jump, but unfortunately wasn't able to react to it at the time.
Oh, well, he went for it.
I was holding forward on the bottom side.
Good play by Declan there. Locked him down on the fireball.
Good fireball. Predicting the jump. I mean, if he's using that, if he's using the fireballs in that way, Ultra 2 may be a better option for him. I can't say whether... one or two of the better used for this matchup. But
this
specifically for that situation, Ultra 2 nets you a nice little bit of damage after a successfully excited shot.
I think you might be right about that, because predominantly you want to do that. So if you tag him with an EX at any point, you want to tag that on the end.
I mean, he's not one of the bigger characters vertically, that means you can do it from nearly any range and still have it connect. I suppose a good use for Ultra 1 is if you bait out any EX Messiah by jumping in and then jumping back immediately, you can just pump the Ultra 1 and punish straight away.
Oh, very good. That was a nice hand play there. Definitely showing he has got, like, you know, a medium grasp of Sagat's normals, which is good. Oh, yeah, that's his throw? What?
I think maybe the throw was too late, but yeah, it certainly should have gotten caught.
Oh, I see.
I'd like to see Declan use standing hard kick a little bit more. Not, I mean, as an anti-air, but just sort of in that situation where they both push each other out. Standing hard kick's a good option, just in case the other guy jumps. And if not, it pushes Sagat a little bit further away.
Oh, very good whiff punish there. Rob's looking for the... Oh! That was very nice.
Pressure.
Well, it takes a good sweep. Rob's showing fort points, just what is this?
And Declan showing pride, he wasn't turning that ultra.
Oh, very good anti-air.
Declan sort of... he stopped doing anything once he saw the EX Messiah hitting.
Yeah, I mean...
It allowed Rob to get a little bit of a reset for the overhead. He's always been looking for that, just in case.
No, I'm not sure that he realises that it's a very easy move to bait, but... Yeah, that was
good easy to do. He got him out, good easy meter.
I mean, he's behind on meter, but it's... I think it's less important for him than it is for Rufus, so... Good block there. And he's creating some space to talk, just, yeah, there we go. Oh, no.
Hey, great.
Rob showing no pride at all, just doing it.
I want to get that damage.
Very good DP there.
Yeah, we'll see more of those.
We're connected there as well. Very good tagging knee.
Very good tagging knee, because it wasn't going to be unsafe.
Don't tag the DP again. Oh, but Nathan made that one. One out of five will hit. That's the rule.
A bit of lack of pride showing through. Now he's going to do it.
Now he's playing Sagat. That's how we do it. I like that. That was a nice chunk of damage.
Gives him good screen space as well. If that was a reaction, that was very nice.
Yeah. I think Rob was predicting the fireball there to sort of go through, but...
Good jump. Doesn't convert, unfortunately. So that's light normal to combo into. Quite
really
difficult, quite unique for the rhythm for the rest of the card.
Oh no! Rob normally doesn't miss that. And not anymore. What a one?
That is the reason why I...
Oh no! And the king is going to show him how it's done.
The gap back to Monty Super is the reason why I try and spend that fourth bar with the gap as soon as possible. Do you try and do a Tiger Knee and you accidentally hold a forward while you're doing it? Super, ruined your day.
Oh, I know. Same with Ken. Exactly the same. You can't do a DP from Carlton unless you're going to get super every time. Unless you go back to neutral first. Pain in the ass.
Definitely a little bit. I want to close this out.
I think he's afraid of the bomb. Oh, there we go.
There we go.
That can take it.
All right. Well, the same game by both players.
It was a nice match to watch. I enjoyed that match. Yep, Rob's just knocked Declan out with a fight stick. He's not happy about that. Declan's dead. No standard, it happens. Why would you do that?
My Puma got body, so I'm just like...
Just getting the next match called out.
Get Ollie to teach some Puma.
Okay.
Ollie's got all the setups, man. I think we've got Ziv going up against Ben. Ooh. That top tier match already, let's go. Sit down, man. Can't lock this solo, man. Again, oh my god, I'm carrying my robot. You say that? I went into the toilet. I heard someone from Barry. It's
the battle of
the 1-2-1-2. Mic test. Yeah, we good?
This is a special occasion.
It is, yeah.
I love my games with Lou on Marvel.
You 5-2'd him last week. I've got a mic my own. Oh no, it's too professional. I can't do this. I don't like this.
Well, Lewis seems to have five.
Well, I first five every week. He's playing out Ben versus Zid. Well, Zaus versus Zid.
I'm joined by Shenan again. The one, the only, the best game in the UK. I said it, and I'll say it again.
He's starting out pretty strong.
As much as the old faithful, you know. Why is Simon slipping? Ollie, it's the counter there. Oh, okay. Man.
Vortex set up in the corner. Caught with grab. Gonna go for a short. Why did he go for another grab?
Went for another grab. That was ballsy.
Ziv has got a brass bollocks.
Yeah.
There you are, shoot the street by side.
Oh, he's cool, so good. He snipes with that so much.
Nice.
He's a sniper. He's a sniper.
Activate sword.
Okay, that's it for first
round. Takes it first round of the first game of the 2-out-of-3 set.
Zid looking to push it to the corner by the looks of things here.
Cool with the sweep, going for a demon.
Beautiful counter into pro there, goes for an even foot setup. Crosses, oh wow.
Cool with the counter hit again. Unfortunately, doesn't make much of it. Got to the EX.
I like what he's doing here, he's not overcommitting. He's just walking into
the corner. This is his game to win.
Yeah.
Not anymore.
What was that?
Ooh, that was the new tech.
Are we back to the fireball?
Using soul fireballs.
I mean, Who can win this with one combo? I mean,
he has all the meat out. There we
okay,
go.
This is
now
be it.
This is it. This is
okay. Go.
Hitting the front with the demon flip.
I think the other way out of that might have been maybe the Exalto, but I think he might have gone.
He could have
for it.
Both went back that shot. Just, I think he had enough health to do it. Went to the demon flip overhead again. Caught with a tattoo. Simon's poking his finger in places it shouldn't be. Fast down the heavy kick, went for the focus attack, keeping the pressure on, using the things that drive it to get in.
I like this adjustment, it's very good. It gets out there with the EXL spiral.
I would not have got
into that. Right? That's a good block by Dallas. Call the fireball, dive kick again.
Locks him in the corner, he's gonna get the free kick now.
Gonna use the balls, push him in the corner, keep him there and get some kick. Ooh, use the fireball to
snipe. That's very smart, it's very smart.
As you would say.
What?
Use the fireball to snipe.
Snipe! Snipe those orbs.
So bad. Go with the crouching fierce anti-air and this is close to being taken. However, one demon's still,
oh,
I
yeah.
think that's what it was going to do, empty jump demon.
I thought it was going to be like the first time again, to be honest.
So that first game
I
goes
to
Zeus.
Yeah, empty jump ultra, let's go.
Where's Marquee?
It's the battle of the century! Fight!
Rob took me down, I'm sorry. I don't know where
the last drill.
Okay, okay.
Zid is in there. Doing all this pressure right now.
I look back and Zid is taking this one so dominantly. That down, concentrated.
Really hard. Activated cyborg mode. Take the first round, but the second game. Look at him thinking. Oh my god, the three hard blinks in a row. He is not ready to play around anymore. He's going to take this.
Zid's clearly not happy with what went down in Northampton last week. He's come back stronger than ever, and I think he's just going to body everybody today. That might happen.
We'll see.
Well, my Ken's not in the tournament, so you guys are fucked. Dallas has made it. Oh, auto correct. I don't know if he meant it, but it was God.
I am Simon's tag, yeah. Yeah.
Breaks the arm of that.
Works
goes for the whiff on
low. Get it. See? I got hard working kids.
Again, he's snatching with that EX Solfo.
Oh, he's going in now, he's got loads of meter to blow, keep him in the corner, keep the pressure on.
Oh, throws him in.
Throw.
Oh, yeah, you saw that coming.
Demon, that's not going to catch. And that's going to be 2-0 to Zeus.
That,
goes
that
further on.
No means free, but...
He just made a bad mistake there with
that,
the demon.
Just that one
I guess
there.
That was maybe a Hail Mary. Yeah, 2-0.
One thing I've noticed about Ben, he's always very careful about people's ultras. I mean, when he sees that they've gone, he doesn't press that often.
It's because he's a smart and perceptive player.
He's a smart, perceptive, adapting, downloading machine.
He doesn't blink hard. He just goes in. Doesn't lube up. Just goes in dry. Gets it done. It's finished. Declan's up. When's Marvel? Never, because that game is shit.
When's Marvel? When indeed, eh? When indeed. I'll tell you when.
Is it?
Next Wednesday on Spooky Stream, that's when that is.
Is it Declan versus
Zeus?
We need
too many shout-outs. Well, shout-outs to Indy, by the way. He's not here. He's working.
Our American-English buddy.
He's grinding out that barrel rug in his hotel room right now. Shout-outs to him. We're missing the American hype this week. It's cool.
We are.
Shout-outs to Northampton. Why aren't you here looking for a bench?
Because they got bodied.
They got
absolutely.
I thought they would come down here en masse, baseball bats, everything.
Yeah, no one's going to play against you again.
Looking for the revenge.
No one's going to play against you.
I mean, I abandoned myself from the tournament.
Dreams. You abandoned. Made them cry. You made him cry. One I guy, I saw him. Tears run down his face. He ran out of sight.
I feel like I cost them money somehow. Like they went to university to learn Street Fighter.
You're lucky they didn't put money in that team tournament because they would have got rinsed.
Hey, they're lucky I got a phone call. Well, no, Northampton was godlike. Shout outs to Ollie for putting
that.
You
were essentially a bailiff. You went and broke the knees and took the TV.
And the thing was, I was going to play Yang.
Wow.
No, the thing is, Ken's a much better character.
He is. We got Declan playing Gap versus Zaus's Rose. I don't know anything about this matchup, but I have a feeling.
This matchup, I feel Rose wins it. Because you're just giving him meter every time you start to get a card.
And the damage boost.
Exactly. Big chunk of damage there.
But, I mean, you never know. Declan might have some tricks in his bag. I don't think he does.
Declan ain't got nothing.
Declan's Dr. Random.
Apparently, I need to replace her with your Tiger Shot with Sulfur, and he'll be happy.
Yeah, pretty much. But at the moment, all Gat needs is one Ultra, and that'll even it up a little bit.
I wonder if Rose can absorb, reflect his Ultra 2 without any extra flex.
No.
That would be so
sick. It only does 2. Or, no, actually, I assume it has special properties, but I know you can reflect EX red fireballs.
Yeah, you can. Ben takes that. I mean, that was predominantly just spacing and normals there.
I don't know, I'll be honest though, Declan got half life. That's pretty commendable.
Yeah, it is. Declan's not known for Street Fighter, but.
Declan's known for his Marvel.
He's known for that. Like, that was his.
Morrowfest
indeed. And he went for the closest Marvel in character. I mean, he could have played Dalsim, but he doesn't play fireballs, could he?
Yeah. He doesn't have enough teleports, man.
Oh, he slaps that right back in.
And Zaus has full meat, so he's just going to blow all that butter and cook a nice pancake with his face.
Oh, we didn't cancel that. I was expecting.
Caught with the silky fucking scarf. Let's go, Ben. Zaus is going to rape Gat.
I'm just going to say it. He sniped him with that ultra.
Declan, you're free. You're free, Declan.
I started shenanigans calling out people already. Wait!
I like Declan.
Oh, shout out to Louis, because he's not here. He said he's ill or some shit, so.
Said it. His sinuses.
Apparently, he's not well, so, yeah. Okay.
Go ahead.
Did we just get a package of Ollie Bollocks from Rob? Do that again. Come on, be scared of Louis, man. I'll be scared of Louis.
That Macedonian tech.
That Macedonian tech. That MP. That PT. Oh, this healer.
Louis BT free.
He's not here to defend himself, it's fair.
Nah, that was mean of me. Louis gets combos every.
That's quite possibly worse than what you just said.
Probably.
But yeah, he does. Oh, you know, shout outs to Pro Fluke, he's not here.
He's in Margate helping out Joe Shaw winning the event. We know the outcome of this match, so there's not that much point commentating it. Declan is doing post attack forward and he's just got caught.
Oh no,
that's
way hasn't. Too late.
Why did he EX? Why did you do that? Why did you.
Why?
Why? Declan.
He should have given him the King's Fireball.
Why, Declan?
The King's
Declan,
Fireball.
Declan, please.
Please, Declan.
Not like this, Declan.
No wonder he's asking when Marvel is. He's like, fuck this game, when's Marvel?
When can I do a combo?
When is it?
When can I do a combo?
He's like, screw me, please, I need my Marvel again. Where is it? Oh, very good back dash.
Caught with a throw, using the soul ball and keeping out.
Oh, got caught with a camera 2 times.
That's the timing is up today.
At this point, I feel he's just delaying the inevitable.
If he can get around, I won't call him free anymore.
Hey, man, he's took
but
it down
to be honest with you,
oh,
I barely ever get around.
Oh, no. Combo's locked everywhere right now.
Oh, he went for the combos.
Well, Declan's got those.
Declan has execution. He could play Viper if he wanted, but he doesn't want to learn matchups.
After this match, I need to put this off because I need to put it super bad.
Fair enough. This is about to be... If he can take this game...
Oh, no, no, it's... I think it might be done.
This is chip territory now. This is chip territory! Oh.
Declan!
Declan, come on, Declan!
Declan, please!
Declan, please! Declan, oh, please! No. Declan, please! Why? Why, Declan?
Declan,
why?
Please!
Why didn't you tiger shot?
Zaus
why?
Takes it. I'll be right back.
Declan, please! 2-0 to Zaus.
And then he never did it, and I just kept getting hit by fireball.
It's 2-0. Zaus moves on again into the winner's semis, I believe.
All right.
Talk about the match. Well, basically, yeah. I like did loads of stupid shit. Yeah, and yeah, I died.
Yeah.
I know.
Fair enough. It's.
I still don't know that match very well. Like, it seems that I sort of need to. I don't know. I was getting better.
Yeah.
The game, but I still was like. He's going to do something now, and I just throw out random tiger uppercuts.
Yeah, there were quite a few random tiger uppercuts. Yeah. Although, you resisted the urge to tiger knee, which is what I was sitting there waiting for. I was hoping for a tiger knee so that I could ultra it, and you just didn't do it. So I was quite disappointed.
I actually noticed that you were trying to do the ultra.
Yeah.
So I was like, okay, I'm just going to throw like really random tiger shots and hope that I get away with them.
Yeah, well, her ultra can go through fireballs, but it's really bad at it. Yeah. It's absolutely terrible at it, so it's not really a very good idea.
Be, like, you pretty much have to hit that max range, otherwise you'll just get hit out of the ultra.
Yeah, exactly. And I think, I'm not sure, but I think it only works on the faster fireballs. I think the slower ones will hit her out of it.
I don't know.
I think so.
I actually don't know.
I'm not sure. that was quite a fun match anyway.
Yeah, it's weird, because, like... Yeah, I don't know. I still don't know how to play the matchup properly.
Yeah, it's a weird matchup. I mean, I think Sagat does have the edge in it, but it's a match that a lot of Rose players complain about and think it's terrible. Actually, I don't think it is that bad. I think it's like even or maybe just ever so slightly in Sagat's favour. But it's not a bad matchup for Rose, really.
Yeah, I think it's kind of even. I feel Sagat has to sort of guess a little bit, like, but he pays off way more if he gets the right guess. Like.
Yeah, he does, but at the same time, I mean, when you're at full screen, for example, I feel like Rose has to work a lot harder than Sagat. Like, it's a lot easier for Sagat to throw varying, like, timing and speed fireballs than it is for Rose to reflect more perfectly, which is what she basically has to do at that range. Yeah. It takes a hell of a lot of concentration and reactions on the Rose player's part, and really not that much at all on Sagat's part.
Sagat is just like, EX. He just sort of, like, picks numbers out of his head. And
yeah, exactly.
So we've got Jimmy and Chase here.
Yeah, this should be a good match. I haven't seen Jimmy here for a few weeks, so I hope he's been working on some stuff.
I've seen some of his jury stuff. It looks really good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen some stuff that I didn't know she could do.
Yeah, she's got some really sick hidden tech that no one really uses. A lot of it's a bit sort of beyond the realms of actually being useful in a real match, but some of it's really not.
Yeah, I don't know. The problem I have with jury is like she's just so negative. Like, if you look at her frame data, nearly everything is minus. She can't tech throws if she's going to do a combo that's
going
to hurt
you. Well, in fairness, like, a lot of normals in this game are negative if you look at frame data. Like, almost everyone's are. Like, Rose, I'm pretty sure, for example, has some of the best normals in the game. I'm pretty sure she only has one that's positive on block.
Well, Jury's a negative on hit. Like, pretty much all of them.
Okay, that's a little bit different. But really nice play there from Chase anyway to take it.
Doing the roly-poly to get the trip out. Oh, and he gets his combo into the super annoying kicks that last for 2 years when you're getting hit by them.
Yeah. And that's the second time I've seen Chase go for that tonight on Jory. It doesn't look like the cross-up setup works on her, or either that or Jimmy's just blocking it correctly.
Well, but either way, skinny.
I saw him doing it in casuals earlier and it wasn't working out for him then. So, I don't know, I kind of feel like he should have learned from that.
That waterfall kick missed because he was in the corner.
Like, interesting choice of Ultra 2 as well. Oh wait, no, actually I do know exactly why he's picked Ultra 2 in this matchup. No, not for Wake Up Ultra because that's always a terrible idea.
Yeah. I think he was trying to punish the leg lift, but...
No, I think he uses Ultra 2, if I'm not mistaken, to punish the pinwheels, to punish EX pinwheel. I think that's what it's for.
He can probably do that. He might be able to catch her dive kick out of the air as well.
Nah, I wouldn't bet on that personally.
I don't know, her dive kick does lose to like pretty much everything.
It does, but it's so easy for her to vary the timing on it and the angle that it goes at that it's a really risky proposition for Gen.
The problem with it is that it has the startup, where she like sort of lifts her leg in the air and laughs, and then she comes down quickly.
Yeah.
So you can get to that if you're looking.
But really nice adjustment there from Jimmy.
Yeah, Jimmy.
He's just taking he's been talking about the theory of the matchup without actually commentating on the match.
He's been using that jumping fierce punch that like lowers her jump up, like it pretty much drops to the ground quicker, and he uses it as a cross up.
Good jump in there from Chase. I don't know quite what Jimmy was going for. I think it was just a badly timed footsie normal rather than an essential anti.
And this is his link there.
Very nice. Okay, so fairly even at the moment, but Chase edging away with that life lead. He's in a really nice position now. Jory with no meter, not the best wake up, and that should have been it, but
that move.
Very little that Jimmy could do.
Yeah, I have no idea how to get away with that move.
A bit relieved about that. So again, Jory in a pretty awkward situation, starting off the round with no meter.
Yeah.
Whereas Gen, you know, slight life lead, 2 meters, and this is going to be big damage. Jimmy's not going to be happy about this. I hope he doesn't let, you know, being in this situation get to him, because he does have a tendency.
He won't be able to kill off this thing, but
you know,
he's probably
getting
on the bottom or something.
And Chase just going for swag. That was such a terrible idea in practicality. The amount of meter that he spent and the damage he got, but it's going to really annoy Jimmy and frustrate him. And you know,
he went for that cross up again, but it didn't work.
Yeah.
So it's 1-1.
I think psychologically it was a good choice to go for it.
Yeah.
Maybe in terms of how much damage he got for that meter, maybe not.
Yeah.
But evens it up very, very well. He's obviously made a good adjustment there. He's working well. He's basically just choosing the right times to jump in, and Jimmy's not blocking the target combo in the air.
He's doing very
he's
good.
Gotta be watching out for that all the time against Gen. And again, get caught by the setup in the corner. Okay, this time he blocked it right. This is his chance now. He's got Gen caught in the corner, and Jory's got some really strong corner pressure.
Yeah, she's actually got one of the best corner pressures in the game.
I'd probably be inclined to agree with that. She's got really strong corner pressure, but he's unfortunately let Chase out now. And now it's going to be really difficult.
Yeah, gets poked.
Yeah, nice footsies there from Chase. Gen with some really, really strong footsies.
Yeah. He's using that crouching medium into hands.
Yeah, exactly. The crouch medium's got great range, and the hands super safe. Yeah. Like armor braid, it's just a really, you know, really strong footsy tool.
Yeah. The hands are good
against nice
everyone
there.
But Fei Long. Fei Long is the only character in the game who can punish Gen's hands.
Even so, he can't do it reliably.
Well, yeah, if you leave the hands out, he gets counter hits. So,
exactly.
Yeah. It's like a mind game on top of himself.
Yeah. Oh, very nice. And that's
into the super.
Jimmy looked strong at the start, but Chase made some good adjustments.
Yeah. He just started frame trapping him. Didn't let Jury really get going.
Yeah, and Jimmy was having difficulty dealing with the jump ins, the different ranges, the different, you know, the target combo, and Chase really exploited that.
And Jury doesn't really have a panic button. Like, she hasn't got like a...
She really doesn't. She's, you know...
Her EX pinwheel isn't that good.
It's not. She's a character with some pretty bad reversals.
Yeah.
Like, her counter teleport thing is not great. Her EX pinwheel is really not great. She's not got great backdash. So it's difficult for her to deal with those situations where Gen really gets his stuff going.
Yeah. She has to be in control to be good, I feel.
Oh, yeah. So we've got Got Rob versus Zid and Stabby coming up.
Zid.
So I'm guessing we'll see Akuma versus Rufus.
Yeah, that's probably. I haven't seen this matchup very much, but I assume Akuma wins just because it's Akuma.
Let me think. I used to main Rufus, so I should know this. Yeah, from what I remember, it's in Akuma's favor, but not quite as much as you might think, mainly just because Rufus's huge damage.
Yeah.
But obviously, Rufus has low stun, Akuma has amazing stun output.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's, you know, that cuts both ways, really. Rufus is a big body character.
Yeah, very.
So I would imagine, you know, he gets hit by some of Akuma's nastier combos and setups. Although that said, from what I remember, he doesn't. Akuma doesn't get both hits of the roundhouse on Rufus if he crouches.
Oh, is he one of those characters?
Yeah, so that's quite nice for Rufus because it takes away one of Akuma's main footsie tools.
Yeah.
Or at least, maybe doesn't take it away.
It takes away
at least
he has to be. Combos.
He has to be very careful about how he uses it.
Okay. And Rufus has also got those really long range pokes, which can be quite annoying.
They can be, but obviously Akuma's a character with strong footsies and good ways to deal with them.
Rufus also has got those, is it forward roundhouse? I'm not sure. The one where he just like lifts his leg and becomes invincible for a while.
Yeah, that's just roundhouse.
It's just roundhouse. It's really, really annoying to play against because like, you throw out a move and then he just counter hits you with it.
Okay, so good start off from Rob.
He gets counter hit.
And this is going to be the Vortex. Very nice.
Just goes for the EX Messiah straight
and
out
of the gate. Now, Rob has to be careful about that EX Messiah now because Ollie's got that. Oh!
I've never seen that before.
I like that. Well, I was going to say he got the Ultra 2 locked and loaded. He doesn't anymore. He's just burnt it. Fair enough. But he uses the Ultra 2 basically to try and punish the Messiah kick. He teleports back and then cancels the teleport into the Ultra to punish the Messiah kick. So that's quite nice.
Oh, this is Shuriken. Very, very good DP of Akuma's.
Yeah, very nice.
I think that's the medium one.
Yeah, that was medium.
Yeah.
But yeah, like good reaction from Zid. And yeah, it's a good tool in this matchup.
Especially with Rufus relying a lot on dive kicks.
Oh yeah.
For like most of his frame traps.
I mean, you kind of... Very nice again.
Yeah, again. Not letting him jump.
Yeah, and good corner pressure here from Zid.
Oh, that must have been a misinput. I think he wanted teleport.
No, he didn't want teleport.
I don't know. I just don't think he wanted.
I kind of think he did want that. I mean, I'm not sure, but I don't see what else he would have wanted.
Oh, smashes it out. No, it doesn't get the ability.
Rob with those execution arrows.
It's a sweep, and now this is.
He's stuck in the vortex.
Oh, pushes
really
in the corner
to get out.
Out.
And he's trying to bait the Messiah kick.
Exactly. This is still very close.
Yeah, Rob's still got a good chance here.
Yeah.
Oh, that was
that
sick.
That was a great read. Oh, unlucky though on the throw.
Okay, I mean, yeah, Zid took the round. Very well played to him, but
that was a micro read.
I love that EX Snake Strike read. That
it's
was
like,
sick.
How'd you
That's
know?
Like my favorite moment.
Oh, gets a counter hit on the roll. Oh, Akuma's like. Frame traps and just these buttons in general, they're all so good.
Oh yeah.
So many good buttons.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Ooh,
just
misses the sweep after it though, so that really weakens the power of his vortex.
Yeah, because he doesn't get the unsecable knockdown.
Yeah, exactly. And now he's given chance Rob a chance to get out. Yeah.
Just into the corner.
Oh yeah. Rob with an excellent punish. Saw that one coming.
It's not quite a kill. But
one
anything.
Mix up. Oh,
teleports
should
out.
Have been waiting for that. Ooh,
now this is kind of dangerous because it doesn't work on the red fireball.
Oh, Rob, you're breaking my heart.
So close.
But playing well. Really good,
really good presence
of mind to go for Raw Ultra there. I really like it.
Yeah. He didn't go for Target Combo Ultra either because that scales it quite a lot.
Yeah.
Oh, doesn't get a double overhead.
Oh, and there, that could have been a free punish. That's what I'm talking about, whipping the second hit of that roundhouse. But Rob, unfortunately, not aware of it, not looking for it.
Oh, gets the EX Messiah again.
He caught him out. He did the dive kick to make the DP whiff and just failed to punish.
Now, Rob needs to be careful because the Parademon is available here.
Oh, yeah. And that's going to be coming out right now. Oh!
I think he was expecting the missile.
Oh, God!
Oh, gets the cross-up dive kick, but doesn't get the target combo afterwards.
I'm dying.
The glink. Rob, that was Rob dead. Oh! No, he's not going to hit! Oh, it was too slow. That pokes him out. Oh, that's very well played, though, by both players.
Rob.
Just unlucky
just
by Rob.
Just wanted you to take it, Rob.
He needs to tidy up a little bit.
Yeah.
But he's getting
if he cleans up his play.
Then yeah, he's very, very good now.
Yeah. He could have been a very, very, very serious threat at that match. Yeah. Even, well, no, even as it was, he was a very serious
yeah,
threat.
Yeah, he was,
that.
Definitely.
He'd have taken, you know, he
just
had
a
lot
few
of opportunities
mistakes.
To take it, yeah.
And against the Kumo, that's what it takes to lose.
Oh, yeah. But very nice play from Zin.
Yeah, very nice play.
Yeah. Not taking anything away from Zin. He played well.
Very good player. Just looking at the brackets here. Who have we got next?
Okay, so next up, I'm just waiting for the next match.
It's like we've got Zid versus I don't want to block.
Oh, okay. This should be an interesting match.
Jury versus Akuma. Unless Jimmy goes for a different character, he plays quite a few characters.
Yeah, Jimmy has quite a roster of characters. Yeah. So
I know he plays Ryu, Makoto, Jury.
Yeah, Chun-Li, I think he plays a bit of.
He might play a bit of Chun-Li, yeah.
Yeah. I've even known him to play Dan.
yeah, he does like to troll online with Dan.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so this should be interesting. I'm not sure if I've seen these guys play before. If I have, it was certainly a while ago. It's not been recently.
Yeah, I don't think I've seen these two players play before. Yeah. Even though they're here quite regularly.
Yeah.
The bracket gods haven't put them together. That's why I prefer Sagat's Ultra 2. I prefer Sagat's Ultra 2 because a lot of in the corner his Ultra 1 is so stupid. It's
I mean, I can't believe they've left it like that.
Yeah,
it's
I know.
Vanilla, to be honest.
Have you seen it against other Sagats? It just completely whiffs and it's punishable on hit.
Really?
Yeah.
Jesus
like,
Christ.
Sagat just like, because he's so big, he like falls out of the corner.
Yeah.
And the big uppercut cinematic just whiffs.
Yeah.
And then he's punishable. It's really, really stupid.
Jesus Christ.
But Ultra 2 is better in the matchup anyway, just for the Fireball War.
Yeah. But yeah, that's true. That Ultra's a really good matchup for Fireball matchups, isn't it? So
I hate the Sagat Mega match, though. It seems really random.
Yeah,
so we got Jury versus Kuma.
Okay, so here we go. This will be interesting. And a matchup that I've not seen a lot, maybe at all.
I've played
a lot of Jury players, so this will be interesting.
Yeah, I've played a bit of it on both ends.
Ollie's starting off really strong here.
Yeah. I don't know, I think Akuma probably has the advantage just because Akuma is probably one of the best characters in the game.
Well, yeah, I mean, if I don't know a matchup with Akuma, I just assume it's in Akuma's favor
exactly.
Because, you know, he's Akuma, let's face it, almost all matchups are in
his
favor.
Yeah, he's using that cross-up very well with the jumping roundhouse, jumping fierce even.
Yeah.
He gets a dive kick.
Very nice. And that should be it.
That dive kick from Jury is so confusing because you see a jump back and it's like, oh, I'm going to go chase it down.
Yeah,
and it
it's
the
natural
face.
Reaction to when you see a jump back to like walk or or dash forward and then she just dive kicks and you feel like a twat.
It's really, really confusing.
Yeah.
What Jury does have,
nice combo.
Probably one of the best overheads in the game. She can combo off of it. It avoids low hits, like Sea Vipers does.
I thought she could only combo off it in the Ultra Wad.
No, it's a bit like Yang's. She can combo off it if you space it right.
Oh, okay, so like if you hit it meaty or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, fair enough.
So, yeah, it's very, very good overhead.
Yeah. Oh, but Jimmy with a good chance here. He's got, you know, corner pressure. Really good chance to get something going. Oh, good counter hit. Oh,
German
nice
jump off
escape.
Damage
this
slap.
Is excellent play there from Jimmy. I really like that. Oh. Looks like I've got Gamma Slap joining me on commentary. Declan tags out, taps out. That's how I roll.
How do you do that? Seriously, when I play those,
it's the same motion as a Shoryuken. And then you press two buttons for the X version.
You're blowing my mind, bro. You're blowing my mind. thought there was some secret tech, but no. Yeah.
It's just a move. Anyone can do it, you know. It's not just me.
Bye.
So, very close game here. Jimmy on the verge of taking it against Ziz. Oh, a nice escape there. Oh, great anti-air. Oh! And that's 1-0 to Jimmy.
See, now, last time I saw Jimmy, he's still not in a rage.
Yeah, he has a tendency to get a bit emotional, but, I mean, he's playing really well tonight. It's good to see.
I mean,
you know, I guess he's taken he's used the time off to train his jewelry, I guess.
Yeah, his
jewelry
was already really good.
Oh, yeah, his jewelry was already good. Yeah, and that, I mean, that's an issue that a lot of players can have. I'm not going to pretend that that's, you know, something that's unique to Jimmy, because lots of players, that can happen.
I feel that if Jimmy can keep calm, then he's a very, very strong contender.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
His jewelry is just ridiculous.
Yeah. Oh, very nice. Nice combo. And he's in a really strong situation here. But Zid, if he's going to come back, this is how he's going to do it. And Jimmy mashing the crouching light. Is that what he wanted? I guess maybe, in fairness, maybe he figured that Zid was going to go for the throw. He mashed the crouching light to try and duck it, I guess. Oh, a big counter hit there. I think she's kind of underrated. I don't think she's amazing, but I think she's in the top half of the cast.
I think in terms of frame traps, nobody's better than her. Her frame traps are ridiculous.
Yeah, she's got good frame traps. She's got really strong zoning against certain characters. She zones, I mean, in terms of the Rose jury backup, as much as I always go on about Rose because they're a player and she's the only character I know anything about, Jory's like the only character that can outzone Rose, basically. And again, really nice play from Jimmy. No, well, yeah, Dalsim kind of to a degree, yeah, I guess. Yeah. But very big damage there from Ollie. But again, Jimmy in with a good chance here. Oh, nice, yeah, nice little setup. I like that. Oh, just misses the combo. Oh, good anti-air. Yeah, and Zid's having real difficulty dealing with it. Jimmy takes it. Very, very nice play. Zid looking quite uncomfortable in the matchup, I have to say.
Jimmy takes it?
Yeah.
Over Ollie?
I mean, you know, Zid.
Over Ollie?
One of the favourites here. Very, very nice play there by Jimmy.
Whatever you know, he did, whatever and training regiment he went on, I think I need it because he came out real strong this week.
Oh, yeah. He was looking real strong there. Right. Jimmy looks like I'm up.
Right, Zaz, good luck. I'm joined by Zid.
Hello.
It looked like you were really unfamiliar with that matchup. I mean, Jury's just...
I've certainly played Jimmy a couple of times. I haven't played many other... I've played two Juries in the past, 6 months. Yeah, Chase is just saying about the stomp. I was definitely fooled by that a couple of times.
I mean, I think her biggest strength is the fact that she can jump at you, but you can't jump at her.
Yeah. Yeah, Jimmy was certainly on point with anti-airs.
Everything. I've seen it beat, just the weirdest things in the air. On the wall.
That's pretty good for Jury.
To see. I mean, Why can't everybody have an anti-air like that?
It would be nice if there was one, just beat all anti-air. With some actual footsies. Now, like I say, I mean, I've not played too many juries recently. I wouldn't say it's unfamiliar familiarity with the matchup. Akuma's got some nasty shit against jury. Just couldn't get that going, but
Yo. Are you entering? I want to see your review. With me?
And now for something completely different.
Olha que coisa mais linda, mais cheia de graça. Ela, menina que vem e que passa. Um doce balanço, caminho do mar. Moça do corpo dourado, do sol de Ipanema. O seu balançado é mais que um poema. É a coisa mais linda que eu já vi passar. Ah, por que estou tão sozinho? Ah, por que tudo é tão triste? Que existe a beleza que não é só minha, que também passa sozinha. Ah, se ela soubesse que quando ela passa, o mundo sorrindo se enche de graça e fica mais lindo por causa do amor.
Each one she passes goes, ah.
Young going in.
I'm surprised. Just let's go back to wondering why they're playing their ults. Have they discussed this?
Why is it again worse? Who's commentating this match here, and the guy on the left playing the girl, and the guy on the right playing the dude? Well, they can't, that's the point.
Yeah, they hear it afterwards.
And then they can watch it back on the phone. No, if they can hear what we're saying, like, then they can get clues as to how to win.
Yeah.
Belly.
So Ben wins.
No.
No.
I just don't like people getting in my dude's face. That's why I don't like that.
Nah, you just have to sit there and do nothing. As soon as you start actually doing stuff,
that's why I stood up just like.
No, I know, but that's the thing. That's the thing. Like, you can't. That's why I didn't stand up. You can't do it.
Yeah, I don't like it, man. I don't like it when people get in my friend's face like that.
Nah, I'm all good.
I'm all good. But like, for me, I stand up just to let them know that if you do something, you're getting knocked out.
Well, that can happen afterwards, you know. Like, he's already trying to bend my fingers back and stuff. I'm like.
You're just like, nah, you're not taking that. I just don't like that. I mean, he was cool and all, but then he just got a bit violent. You know, I don't like that. Not letting that happen to nobody.
Well, no, absolutely. Absolutely. But it's just, if you don't let it get to that point, nothing will happen, so.
You are a calmer man than I, right? Me? Someone gets in my face.
Yeah, maybe catch me a little bit angrier, then something else might happen. But yeah, nah.
All of a sudden, you're just like, nah.
I've got my head there at that point. That's okay.
Proper commentary now.
I've not. Is this guy? This guy story. Mike. This guy Mike the Barog. I've not seen him play yet. This Pad Barog. I think this is Mike. I think. Hopefully this is the button check.
Jimmy's a button. Oh yeah, button check. Okay, cool.
Well, I say hopefully it's a button check. I mean, I'd love to see Jimmy Zabuki. I just don't think he has one.
At the same time, it was, but I kind of wanted him to leave.
I was okay. I'm fine.
I think I'm a bit too protective. What are you standing up to? Like?
Nah, that's the thing. Like,
what are you standing up for, bro?
What are you standing up for? Nah, you just. I've been in that situation before. You just do nothing and wait until it stops happening, you know?
Yeah. I know how you feel, man, but like, I don't like seeing my boys in that situation.
Yeah.
It's better for us to let that guy in there and get surprised into it. You know, it's not going to be good for him. So.
That's true. But I don't. I judged him to be a person that wouldn't just stop. So.
Once again, you've got like these comes into play.
That Yomi.
That Yomi. Okay, so Jimmy playing Cody. Are we going to see a Cody that
has
combo?
Has Jimmy got a Cody?
I mean, it looks like
I don't remember.
Louis on Blast one. Oh! This Barrow has got combos,
though. Oh, the overhead, the return of the overhead in a different form.
Okay, this guy's. I mean, I think he's playing Barrow collecting money in another character.
This is a slobber knocker right now. Both guys wanting to stay in.
I don't agree with the waste of meter, but it got him the win. He's really behind the meter right now. He's going to take a few minutes on the way.
I'd say when you're one round up, I think that's okay. Personally, I think when you're one round up, spend the meter to get that first one. You can spend the second round just trying to chip away, and if you get meter and the win, great. I mean, if you get meter as well and lose, you're fine for the third round.
I mean, I don't know how I feel about that waste of meter like that. I mean, it's pretty
good in the suit. Oh, I see. Yes. Blocks the overhead, very good. Didn't get much damage off it, unfortunately. You do need to capitalize on those situations to make Barog scared of using the overhead, because I know that once, if you don't stop the Barog using it, eventually you'll get hit by it.
I mean, it stands to reason that pretty much once you said you would get hit by it, and at some point you will forget about it.
Yes.
I think it was Jack, he came here and he hit me twice in a row. It went overhead, crouch face overhead, and I was like, you are fucking shitting me right now.
One situation was, his overhead was so powerful. There was one situation where I did block it successfully and then did an uppercut, but it didn't come out as a reversal, so it didn't punish.
Indy was telling me that when he does the EX overhead, actually hitting the armor activates the overhead. So if you hit it before it gets there, it will activate it.
I did not know that.
No, I didn't know that. So
I'd love to test that.
It comes in, I didn't land forward with them.
Yeah.
And it comes out immediately.
Ah.
It activates at the point where the armor gets soaked.
So you have to make sure if you're going to stick out a normal that you have to cancel it into a special.
Yeah, Indy did tell me that all you need to do is walk forward and throw. It
yes.
It either doesn't activate or it'll activate when it gets to you, so you have enough time to play.
Yeah, that's the thing I've seen. I definitely remember Filipino Champ doing that a lot with his Dowsim, where he was good in the he was confident in the barrel matchup because he could keep barrel down. If he tried to get him using the meter, he'd just back throw him every time.
He goes for the Hail Mary super boot, ultra boot that Abari crossed around.
So Jimmy going with Makoto. He did stay.
It's not necessarily a bad matchup, I mean, it's not bad. But I think Baron has the advantage of this match. I mean, this is a
Certainly Balrog's sweep is better. I think, I don't know what Makoto's shenanigans are like against Balrog. I feel like because he's a wide character, she's probably got some proper shenanigans.
Well, she's got the four standing mediums, or three standing mediums on the wide body character. But the reason that she has so much trouble with her trial characters is because they're always ready with the reverse.
See.
They don't have to react, they can just hold and wait and wait
yeah.
and wait.
On knockdown though, Jimmy seems to be going a little bit nuts. I mean, there weren't in particular any setups there, but he did get him over the overhead.
Yeah,
okay. Goes to a reset. Didn't capitalise fully, but got some damage anyway.
First of all, I expect an overhead pretty soon. Oh! That was in there. Crazy people in there, that's it. I like that one.
The destroyer of fingers. Super? Oh, I think he went for it.
In fact, I'm just gonna watch it right now.
Commentary on the drink.
Okay, so, I mean, at this point, it shouldn't really try and mix up because he's got all that meat on the right.
Oh!
That's a very good reaction. Why do you... I mean, there... He had a brain fart.
Jimmy should have killed him.
Yeah, he should have killed him.
Should have killed him.
Jimmy! Oh, he's got his earphones. He should have killed him for sure, but...
Got the round anyway, but should have had presence of mind to kill him there, especially in that situation where he needed that combo to kill him. Lose a bracket action. So this is 1-1.
I mean, once Jimmy works out that his focus is very powerful killing this matchup, it's pretty much over for Balrog.
That's true, we've not seen too much of it.
I think he's waiting to bring it out.
It's the battle of the century! Fight!
What's next? I think he's so underrated because he's not a Vortex character.
I just think it's the jab. I think the jab carries him very far in this game. I say 2.5. I've studied the frame data, but I haven't. It's 2.5 though. The thing is, if he wakes up pressing crouch jab, his crouching hitbox moves him so far backwards. If you try and do a meaty setup on Balrog, he moves so far backwards that the rest of your combo won't actually hit. If Akuma walks up to him and does a meaty crouching medium punch, if it counter hits, he can't do another one. You have to confirm off of that one hit and do either sweep or standing hard kick.
Hit him with the indie special though.
The crouching medium punch FADC.
Yeah. I'm just torn.
I think I'd we're seeing some shenanigans. Why no ultra? I'm sure he's got his reasons. We'll see something. Unfortunately, and he's out. Should have done the ultra off the command grab, and I'm sure he knows it.
Is that it?
So Mike goes on to face... Is this losers finals? Where are we at in the bracket, Rob? Losers final coming up. So it's Mike back on.
Are you still in?
Jimmy knocked me out. That jury,
yeah,
pretty
jury,
much,
yeah.
Yeah.
Jury, yeah. I thought that was the winners.
No, I lost to Ben and then Jimmy.
Gen, now, I do believe Gen owns this match. Because of his wide body, especially as many unlockables.
I've not seen Chase play Indy, so I'm excited to see. I mean, I'm not excited for Mike for this to happen to him if it does happen, where he gets stuck in unblockable land. But I'd like to see it.
Yeah, it's the same pretty much the same business as with Cody. If he gets the medium or the light, I think, up kicks, and if he misses early for the hard knockdown, he should be able to unblockable lead him to death. But basically, he'll know what to do over and over. The same thing with Ken, that's why when I got. Me and Chase have banned the game Ken matchup. for the sake of our friendship, because we're really mad at each other.
That works against Cammy and Sagat as well, does it? I think.
Cammy can crouch it.
Oh, okay. Well, crouch it, then stand up, or she can just crouch block it straight away.
The crouching one doesn't work on camera. It's a cross up first time and an in front the second time, but if she stands, it's unblockable every time.
Okay.
So, but Makoto, she's a wide body character, but this isn't affected by Ogre. She can just kooky argue for free and knock him out of it. It's the only character
this
that
game
can
is
get out for free.
This game is interesting and strange at the same time.
Again, just makes those little weird matchups, you know? Like, when I first started learning Street Fighter for real, like, Chase started teaching me, and all he did was body me for 2 months straight with Gen. He absolutely bodied me, like, and then I started learning the Gen matchup. Once you learn the Gen matchup, you learn that you have to know 101 of his sets.
Yes, certainly. Certainly a character much like Ibuki,
yeah,
whereby to learn to play against her, you need to learn her setups, possibly by playing as her.
Like,
those one-player game characters, I love them.
Yeah. Like you get knocked down with Rusev, this round's over. Well, I should be able to identify when you're putting that jab there for someone jabbing and bashing in. I like that.
I hope the jab is to mask his charge. I hope he's doing that so he doesn't just hold down back, and I hope he's doing it to mask his charge. Really? Wow. He waited a really long time before doing that off the wall.
So that was a standing unblockable. He has two of those fireworks. But I think he identified that he likes to stand and jab.
Does it matter how far away he is from the side of the screen? If they're right next to each other or if they're all the way over in the right-hand corner? How lenient is the timing for it, then? If he can...
I think it's at one or two frames sort of timing.
God damn. Oh, the JS Masters.
Yeah, he is mastering his job. Didn't go for it,
then. So, Mike demonstrating to Chase that he's not got any charge by constantly moving backwards and forwards. So, Chase could feel pretty happy about just walking forwards, to be honest.
That was very nice. I mean, it was a huge round.
It got the round. Good use of Mira, I think.
I mean, you don't often see that. You don't see someone who actually
uses like a jab. Yeah, and you don't want to see people doing it too often. And then people will catch on. Oh, hell, off of this amazing combo. What do we see? Oh, good backdash.
He gets super in 7-3 against everybody.
I'd love to commentate on this. I'm listening to you, Matt. I'd love to commentate. It's I'm honestly just staring at this, just like, wow.
I know a fair amount about I'm gonna let you finish. Ken is the best character in the world. You know? That happens when I commentate with Indy. Once he starts, I'm just like, that was a good setup. That was a good idea. And then I just let him talk for a bit.
His setup cost $1 million. The last hit of the waterfall kicks is missing against Balrog. Is that a timing thing or is that a Balrog thing?
No, he's not.
Ah. Oh, purposely.
Oh no, he's done. Yeah, that's it.
Missed the sweep. Go for it anyway. Yes. Now hopefully we can never see it again. Here's his punishment. Wake up, DP!
That's a 7-frame wake up. 7 frames. Let me just say that again.
How many invincibility frames does it have?
About 10.
Hey.
It's invincible before it even starts. Like, I think it's 0 plus 10 on the invincibility.
Right.
So silly.
Good focus. Unfortunately, the FADC was lost in that and got hit for it, so that was a huge waste of meat, unfortunately. Chase identifying that he was walking in too readily. Hit confirmed into hands. Very well played.
Mike's
gonna watch this back and think, oh, there was so much bullshit in that.
He's gonna watch it back and go, every single time it was a different setup.
I'm playing this game so honestly.
I identified the fact that mine wasn't even halfway down, so that must be yours.
So Gen advancing, Chase advancing on.
It looks a bit like Gen. I mean, if you dye his hair white, he'd be a Gen, right? I could teach him a bit of Mantis. I know a little bit.
Can we call him Pai Mei?
Oh, yeah.
Start to call him Pai Mei.
Pai Mei's got like just stands on the sword. You don't care.
Punching walls with paper in front of it. That's fine.
Plucking out eyeballs. I mean,
plucking out eyeballs.
He's wet suit. He's like, come here.
Oh, they got to play one more game. That's right. It's 3 out of 5. Yeah,
what
that.
Standing up if, for, Chase?
If what you standing up for? Oh, it's over. Unfortunately.
This be the mental guard bait the barrel player was looking for.
Everyone dropped a bollock on that one, apart from Rob.
<He's> like, but this guy's name is. This is Mike Street Fighter 4. That's his actual
Mike
name.
SFIV.
Mike SFIV. Yeah, that almost is like creative as Puerto Rican Balrog. Let me tell you something about Puerto Rican Balrog. It's Puerto Rican, but he gets better. He gets better.
All right, okay, I'm listening.
He's Balrog.
That was the sound of my mind exploding.
On his mind, floating. Oh, he plays Balrog now. Yeah.
Plucking those eyeballs off the floor, because they've exploded.
That's why I get so like. This guy's called Shanani again. Who does he play?
Shanani? Is it Shanani?
Shanani again plays Ibuki. Okay, he's gone for Balrog. I mean. Oh, wait, no, I think he's gone for button check. But Balrog. He's gone for M. Bison. Bison's actually a better pick than Balrog in this matchup.
I feel like Bison would have a really hard time dealing with Gen's jumps, though.
Yeah, he has so many attacks.
Bison's. Oh, okay. Yeah, it's one of those things. Does he have to guess which one he's going for, like all the other characters?
If he's going to try and punish the super champion, he uses EX Stomp. He has to wait a very long time.
Ah, okay.
Whereas if it's EX Psycho Kusher, he can just wait a split second and use it on the back. I mean, standing around that's very good against Gen.
I'm sure Gens have tried this, but I imagine if you're wanting to guess between which options he's going to use and you think he's going to either use backdash teleport or EX head stomp, you could just select dash forwards. Dash forward would get underneath the head stomp. You would lose the Psycho Crusher, but yeah.
That's why I like it. No matter what he does, if you option select right action,
it's a mini game in a game.
Oh,
yes, it hits it. Yes.
It makes the head stomp work.
Okay, so it's not much of a mini game. Ken definitely wins that. Akuma has to play rock, paper, scissors a little bit, but.
Ken wins the game. Yang, for example, does not. Very good forward.
I'm liking this Bison play.
Didn't
like the cancel, especially because he didn't convert. If he'd converted, I'd love the cancel. That was unsafe. Chase capitalizes. Hopefully Mike knows. Hopefully Mike doesn't give him any opportunities to punish anymore. He needs to use light scissors only unless it's a very long range, in which case you can use hard scissors and get away with it. But you can't cancel any normal into anything other than light scissors, otherwise it's unsafe. Good attempt at a frame trap. Chase didn't bite with any tech.
Five-five-fives.
It's got really good pushback as well. Off of one they were at mid-screen, one FEDC. Chase had pushed him all the way into the corner. Punishes the reverse. Very nice.
Game yourself some pupils. Okay, so two stakes. I mean, Bison's a better matchup, but he looks a lot more familiar with Bison than Balrog.
I feel like I definitely would have liked to have seen that set with Bison instead.
Yeah, without the break, I mean, I feel that Chase had a bit more time to compose himself, and that guy was.
I feel like standing up was an unfair advantage to bait the other guy into thinking that it was over to try and get away with the free win.
Oh, I'll be right back though, because I really need to go to that again. I'll be right back.
So, grand finals. Shenanigan. Is it grand finals? Yeah, Shenanigan versus Zaus. Grand finals. Again, coming from losers, must win two sets of 3 out of 5. I'm going to say this is a bit louder than normal. Hopefully they pick their mains. Don't think they heard. I hope they pick their mains. Let's see what characters they pick. After the button check, of course. And we're joined by.
Hi guys.
We're joined by one more thing.
For this final, are we in grand finals now? Aren't we?
Yeah, grand finals. Chase coming from losers must win 2 sets, 3 out of 5. Hopefully these are the characters they pick, but they're probably going to check buttons just here because they've had to go out to the dashboard because of those extra wired pads causing issues with the Xbox 360.
That Balrog just knocked me out a little bit earlier.
Wireless. Salty words.
Not at all. So
no, we were talking about the jab.
Champion. Been probably the winner for the last few weeks now.
He's probably on a streak by now. He certainly won. Certainly won the last one. Did he win the one before that?
Did Chase beat him in one?
Think he did. No, I think the week before that. He's won the. No,
he's
I'm.
Won a few
I'm
guys. He's won
yeah. I'm just gonna keep saying no, and and eventually the answer won't actually come to me at all.
I think we'll be seeing these two characters in the main fight, not the Ibuki Yun.
Yeah, hopefully nobody switches here. So we're live. We have got a costume change for both players though. Pink and green.
Pink and an old man. Just looks weird.
Pie Maker can wear pink if he wants.
Maybe he's sending a message. Maybe no. Pink is cool.
Just so fabulous to look at. It gets distracting. Good poke.
So Chase at the moment trying to just poke from long range. Doesn't want to get too close to.
No one wants to get near Rose. I thought he was going to say Rose. No, one normal, and it's still true. Oh, little bit of dancing there from both players.
Maybe that's what the pink out thing is. It's dancing.
That ballerina again.
Trying to go.
Second
for
one. Second orb didn't combo. It depends on when you activate and which soul throw you do as to whether the first one will hit in front or not. And see, this is what Ben does. He'll let you follow him into the corner, wait for you to go for a cross up, focus back dash, then he's got the whole screen to work with again.
Loses his time on his ultra there. Up until last.
Very good dash forward soul throw, and there for the chip. Gets the chip, I mean.
Just like that.
I would have liked to have seen Chase just try the ultra. It's not going to work, but just do it anyway, I guess. Chase wanted to play passive here. Unfortunately, played a little bit too passive. Just when he decided to attack, got counter hit for it.
Here we go.
Good jump. See the setup. waiting for Ben to do a reversal. My goodness, I thought he was punishable on that. He just threw him instead. Gets another one. Walks forward, walks into a back throw tech.
Oh, and again, he's getting a lot of mileage out of these throws. Another throw, four now. Goes back throw.
Now, unfortunately, Gen's going to have to deal with this chip.
Goes for the risky jump. A lot of people jump at that. I'm not sure why.
Yeah, I was saying this to Ben the other day. I feel like Dan said it best. Northampton Dan said it best. Sometimes you just feel like, it'll work this time. I'll just do it and it'll work. It doesn't.
Just one time out of the 100, you may get in between the orbs. There's a vision for everybody. Get between Rose's orbs, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay, misses the link and Chase capitalizes. Doesn't get another hard knockdown out of the setup, but does get some damage.
Back to the poke.
Chase is very active right now in his button pressing. I'm surprised that Ben's not taking advantage and trying to get in there a little bit and get some counter pokes in. He's content to just sit on the life lead.
Back to the back corner, now chasing the
corner. Here comes Ben's opportunity to focus backdash. Does it before I can say it.
Now has full screen to walk away.
Good anti-air, and now Chase is a little bit boned. Oh!
Just took it. Just
I don't think anyone expected that.
Like that. Unfortunately, one soul spiral. Oh, go.
Chase he's content to keep the meter. Yeah, he didn't want to use any meter, but did want to try and get some damage, maybe use some gimmicks to get the round, but he didn't want to use any meter there unless he was confirming the kill. Good tempo, what are we gonna see?
Oh, nice.
Looked like it poked him out of the soul spiral. That's very nice, and that's very good to know. Both characters have fairly good walk speed. They're able to just walk it's outside of each other's range, making the normals whiff. If they were able to capitalize on that animation and whiff punish,
he's
jumped.
He
yeah.
Oh. Ooh. No.
I'd like to see Chase spend some meter. Doesn't even spend any meter, gets the back throw.
All that health disappeared in a matter of seconds.
So I'm surprised by the slide from Ben after the activation of the orbs. Looked like he was going straight for him. Ben obviously knows something I don't. Here comes the bit in the second game where you just decide, I want to press buttons against Ben, and he smacks you around for it. Too early on the setup, gets back thrown. Chase has been sitting on his meter for a while, not had a chance to spend it.
He made us have to do it soon.
Yeah, it's 3 out of 5, so I mean he's not screwed if he loses here, but obviously in this game, he needs to spend the meter. He can accept the chip, he can accept that. He's just content to sit there and rain. Ben. He's capitalizing on the chip. Unfortunately, didn't confirm. No punish.
Didn't matter in the end.
Ben up 2-0. He wins this next game. He takes the tournament in a very early finish. He'll be taking the early bus home this time.
With his winnings, maybe it's cheaper early on. Maybe that's what he's doing. throw early in the game. Oh, just misses his second.
Seems in this set, Ben's been having problems comboing close down and medium kick into crouching medium punch. Not that that seems to be affecting him too much.
He started jumping a little bit. Definitely a thing with when you get frustrated.
Against Rose.
Just want to get in.
Goes off the wall again. And that back throw tech that works out in your advantage if you're going for a delayed frame trap. Going for the back tech, which turns into a back throw if they just walk up into you. Much the same again. Soul spiral into fireball, into buttons, into death.
Just
It seems difficult. I'm sure that Soul Spiral is punishable, but it just seems too hard to do.
They're not taking any crap this time. Just dealing damage. There we go.
He gets the early bus home. Runs away with his fight money before he gets hit with the pool cue.
3-0 to Zaus, just straight up. Did he lose a round?
Did he lose a round or a game this entire tournament? Probably and hopefully.
He took a round. He lost one against that really good player, One More Thing.
I think he lost to the that Akuma player that... Where did he come at 25th? I don't know. There was some sort of statistic about that guy. He was like the highest ranking Akuma at Street Fighter 20. Highest ranking Akuma. Yeah, that's what he was doing to put guys off.
Not a problem.
So thank you very much, guys. This has been 21st of February, Leicester Bar Fights. Ben takes it again. Hopefully we can end the streak next week.
So we'll see you guys then. There's One More Thing signing off.